We're all guilty. If I couldn't see color, what would I see? So close your eyes with me and imagine this. There's a world where no one else is to blame. In order to imagine this, we must first understand that I am my brother's keeper. A world with no blame would be a world that embraces the responsibilities of someone else's joy and laughter. I don't want this essay to seem like the mediocre I Have a Dream essay just because Martin Luther King had a dream. But what can I say? I have some very strong hopes for this great nation to be better than we have been when it comes to civil rights and unity. Dr. King wanted us to fight for the rights of all people, no matter who you are, where you come from, or what you've gone through. You're a human and deserve to be treated with equality. Because of this, I believe that it is time for us as a nation to stand up and make the changes that we need to in order to become an even greater nation than we are. It's as if we're having a civil war within our nation that hinders us from coming together and becoming even greater than we are apart. Today, it seems as if people care more about revenge than they care about helping each other get to the top. Almost every day, we hear about people dying from black-on-black crime, police brutality, school shootings, etc. When will the foolishness really end? We always seem to blame others for these unbearable acts of injustice we commit against one another as humans, and we get angry when someone else doesn't get the same punishment as someone. But the real question is, even though someone's punishment doesn't fit the crime, does it make what you did okay because yours did? I believe that even Christians fail to remember that there is not a human being on the face of this earth that really has the final say in any situation, and even most non-Christians believe in karma. You see, no matter what your religious beliefs may be, we need to stop focusing on punishments and realize that a lot of our actions are inhumane altogether. See, to me, it doesn't matter if your name is written in history or if you get a trophy for your good actions. But what matters is that you remain humble and you know that what you do is right. If you can't lend someone a ride, pray for the ones at the bus stop that you pass. If you're too far away to speak, wave your hand. If you can't buy a gift, give a hug or a smile. A prayer, wave, kind words, hugs, and smiles all have something in common. They cost nothing. Be a grenade that explodes happiness and kindness into your homes, your businesses, your churches, and your schools. And yes, you encounter those closed-minded people who don't want the world to change, but you have to stay positive. And yes, you encounter those moments where you feel like giving up, but remember that the world needs you to make a change. Now open your eyes to a colorless world.